Hello, and welcome to another episode of Dave Trippin'. The talk at hand today, cars drive by. Is it worth getting a TESOL or TEFL certification to teach English in Japan? Or must you get a TEFL or TESOL certification to get a good job here, or to get a job here more specifically? And strictly speaking, the answer to that question is no. But much in the same way that if someone asked you, is having $1 million necessary to survive, would also be no. But wouldn't it be kind of awesome if you had it? Therein lies your answer. So, to initially get over here, you don't really need it. Don't need it at all. I got over here and many others have gotten over here to be able to get a job, and it's not difficult without one, provided you have that basic four-year degree that gets you in the door. But then that's where things change, and as I've progressed here and learned more, I've come to the conclusion that having a TESOL is incredibly useful if you want to better your position here. So getting in the door, not so much, but were you to move to a better position, were you to desire a higher grade of pay, the TESOL is incredibly useful. And there's all these little fringe benefits of the TESOL that I hadn't considered necessarily, except for those main two, until I started to take it, because one of my subscribers said, Dave, the TESOL is useful, why don't you do it online? So there you go. First of all, if you want to do the TESOL, you can do it online. And when people ask about your TESOL, if you're coming to it a little later like I am, they don't ask you, where did you get your TESOL? They ask you if you have one. So basically, I'm gonna adjust this a little bit. Basically, when they ask, you say, I have a TESOL. And it doesn't matter if it was online or if it was in a classroom that you attained that certification. So that's a really good benefit for somebody who's already started working and grants you a great deal of flexibility. I study for it online. Now, that's the way that you can get the TESOL. In addition to this, the TESOL is actually not just fluff. I kind of thought, oh, this is one of these, you just got to pay the money to get the certification. There'll be no practical use once you start doing the thing. How useful could it really be? And I'm quite happy to be proven wrong in this instance, where when I've started to do the TESOL, at the very least, they do a fantastic job of reinforcing basic grammar, where that's kind of the nuts and bolts of it, and probably the most difficult, as memorizing and having a good knowledge of grammar is quite challenging, but it's well worth knowing, and you'll get a benefit from that, in that when you're in your classes, you're going to be that much more confident. You're going to know what the auxiliaries are, how to properly describe an adverb, how to talk about definite and indefinite articles, a lot of things that we take for granted in our everyday speech that we don't realize that we're using, but every single English teacher should know to be on that somewhat higher level. And I had a decent understanding of this, but the TESOL serves to jog your memory, basically, and does a really, really good job of that. And I found that during the course of my study, there's 20 tests you do with the 120-hour course that I'm doing. They also provide you with a lot of fantastic game ideas. So this is something that, as you read through, you can download all of the different chapters that you're reading, and you keep them on your computer. So the TESOL can actually be a sort of resource you can refer to, having concluded the course, that you can come back to again and again and again and again, and get a great deal out of it. And you're able to do it at your own pace, so if you're incredibly busy, that's no problem whatsoever. You can do it while you've got a little free time at school. I'm working on it today. I had a couple free blocks, and so here I am studying away. So you have that resource at hand afterwards. You got the fact that the TESOL is not actually fluff. It's quite practical for you. You can use it, as I was going into it for, as a leveraging tool. First and foremost, when I come around to my next year, I'm going to say, hey, look, I have this TESOL certification that I did to show you how serious I am about working with you and bettering myself as a teacher. And then you have, beyond being in the job itself, if you're going to apply to jobs, it's going to give you that edge. Yeah. So, you're already here, you're here for a year, and you want to set yourself out from the pack of people who are also applying for all these teaching jobs at this higher level. You want your pay grade to go over 300,000 yen. And there's a lot of competition for that. And so how do you set yourself apart? Aside from having a very specific teaching certification, which will of course then put you up in that even higher level, well, you do something like the TESOL. So it's not so much for first arriving, but it is incredibly useful for any time beyond that to better your position. And for all these other reasons that I mentioned, it's not just a piece of paper. You will actually be a much, much, much better teacher if you do this course. It's as though you're reading just, if you read a book on teaching English as a second language, that's what this is. I've often thought that I would do that, and then I was like, well, I guess this is the most fundamental book that you could read about doing that kind of thing. So absolutely get it if you're going to be here for a longer period of time, and maybe even get lucky like I do. When I bought it, I didn't look at this, but when I received the receipt for it, it said, so the sale ends tomorrow. And it turns out I got it for 350 Canadian, whereas it would normally have cost me nearly 500 Canadian if I hadn't got it on this sale. So watch for sales too. I didn't know you could do that. Not terribly difficult either, as a final note. If you are studying, I'll do like a tips and tricks for the TESOL later on, because I've done 4 of the 20 tests that you need to do. I've scored 100% on everyone so far. I'm so keen. but it's fantastic. It's really, really good. I'm enjoying it so far. I'm surprised how much I've enjoyed it, actually. Very, very useful. So, there you go. Should you get the TESOL? Well, listen to what I said in the video. I think it's pretty clear. If you enjoy videos like this, please do like, subscribe, and share. If you'd care to check out my gaming channel, check that out too. I'm getting on Life is Strange tonight. I've been so busy organizing the rest of my life with the big move and the job change and yada 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 that I haven't gotten to it as much as I would while trying to still keep this channel active. Thank you to everyone who checks out all the videos. I really, really appreciate it, and I'm going to try and always keep this balance of something useful for your job, something that's just cool going out to eat, some funny stuff, that variety. But let me know what's your experience. Maybe you've already done the TESOL, maybe you've gotten a job because of it already, maybe you were on the fence or not, whether or not you should get it, and this could provide you an answer. Regardless, thank you again, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. So ciao for now. Peace.